we're dealing with something powerful on here, saints. The demonic umbrella, the demonic umbrella. If you remember what happened, remember Elijah was saying that, I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. The sound of the abundance of rain is the prophet's reward. Whenever Jesus put a prophet in your life, there's a timing for God to let you hear the sound of the abundance of rain. That abundance of rain is the floodgates of heaven open up over your life. Now the Lord has freedom to release what he's been designed to release all along. So then there's an intensity of favor. The power of God on you goes to another notch. You begin to engage and entertain angels more frequently. Remember the Bible said, let brotherly love continue, that hereby you won't miss entertaining your angel unaware. That means that you can entertain angels unaware if you're not walking in brotherly love. But see, when you walking in love, the love going to link you to the mind of God, because God is love. And the spirit of God going to start revealing to you that this is an angel. You see that? You don't entertain, you got to let brotherly love continue so that you don't miss entertain your angel unaware. See, when you walking in love, because God is love, you walking in God. So now God going to start showing you that this is one of his angels. And when God shows you that, now, not only are you entertaining angels, but now you done switched it. You entertaining angels in your awareness. Having angelic consciousness is the gateway for more miracles. Is the gateway for more miracles. Is the gateway for more miracles. Let's get this correct. Mantle is the power of God established on you for a specified purpose. So when you hear me say mantle, I'm dealing with the power of the Holy Spirit flowing on you for a specified purpose. When you receive a mantle, there's a specific stream in which God is flowing through you to accomplish a desired outcome. Ruth had a mantle for being loyal to Naomi. When she was faithful with that mantle, then she was graduated to a mantle to please Boaz or work in the field. Then she was graduated to a mantle to please Boaz. Let me say it like this. Okay. She received a mantle to overcome the death of her husband. She received a mantle to be loyal to Ruth. She received a mantle to serve in the field, to work for Boaz. Then she received a mantle to please Boaz. There are graduations in mantles. If you master a mantle, God not going to let you keep that one alone. He going to give you more mantles. Isn't it amazing that in Matthew 25, Jesus is talking about money, but then he calls it talents? Because in your talent is your money. You say, I don't know what my talent is. That's why you don't got your money. Satan don't want you to get a revelation of your talent. Because if you get a see this fresh. How many of you, it's already hot. It's fresh what I'm teaching you right here. This is the out of hand new broadcast. It's fresh. It's the new out of hand broadcast. It's fresh. The new out of hand broadcast. If you're on Facebook, share me off. Share me on Facebook. If you're on Facebook, share me on Facebook. We ain't playing no games. Welcome Holy Spirit Fire Conference, October the 4th, October the 5th, October the 6th. Welcome Holy Spirit Fire Conference. I'm releasing the apostolic and the power of God in a mighty way, militant service with the power of the Holy Ghost.
What's the price? Prices, prices, going up. Prices, prices, going up.
That's why the devil don't want you to get a revelation of your talent. Because in your talent is your wealth. In your talent is your money. Have you ever got the revelation that you got billionaire status already inside of your talent? But if you look at your life, the devil combating your talent. He combating your talent. Because watch this. One of your major talents is the ability to seek and to help God Almighty. One of your main talents is to seek and to help God Almighty. See, Adam had a talent. Guess what his talent was? He had two talents, as a matter of fact. Or, watch this, he had three talents. To keep and tend the garden. And then here come the third one. To sow herb-bearing seed. Oh, my God. Watch this. Then God gave him a fourth talent. To not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. He had a fourth talent. So watch this. Then God promoted him to the fifth talent. See, what if the man with the five talents was Jesus talking about what Adam could have did if he would have listened? Oh, my God. See, this fresh what I'm talking about. You'll have to watch the replay more than once to catch this revelation. Let me just tell you this. I have an understanding about something that's real powerful. If you watch a movie one time, you don't really know what happened fully. You got to watch it twice. And saints, if you read the word, a scripture one time, you never got the revelation. You got to read that scripture more than once. And when you read it more than once, then the Holy Spirit going to give you the more than once revelation. When Jesus told that person the talent, the five talents, what if that was Adam? What he could have become if he would have listened. That's what God the Son was showing you. Remember the person got five more talents? Because Adam had five talents. Keeping ten, the garden, that's two. Sow herb and seed, that's three. Don't eat from the knowledge of good and evil, that's four. Now, the woman came on the scene. Five. He had a talent to direct this woman. He had a talent to love this woman. He had a talent to mentor, preserve, prophetically equipped, apostolically invest, train in virtue. Now look at this. You notice when he got to the five, foolishness sets in. Why? Because Jesus told the parable about the five wise virgins and the five foolish virgins. Remember, he told that parable about the five wise and the five foolish. The five wise and the five foolish. Now foolishness sets in on Adam. And watch this. He's functioning like the five foolish virgins, where he's acting like he doesn't have any oil. When you stop sowing, there's a realm that comes on you where you act like you unanointed. When you stop giving yourself to Jesus, there's a realm that comes on you where you act like you unanointed. When you stop meditating the word, there's a realm that comes on you where you act like you're not full of grace and truth. Because that five is all of the grace of God starting to be revealed to you. All of his favor is accessed by his grace. Saints, grace and favor is not the same thing. Grace is God's ability that if you receive it, you'll access the favor. Or you'll have access to what that ability births. Saints, let me just say this. Casting out devils is grace. But receiving and believing on Jesus is favor from what that grace brings. Speaking in new other tongues is grace. Receiving mysteries from speaking in new other tongues is the favor that grace brings. Faith is by grace. So they're neighbors. Faith is grace. The mountain moving is the favor that receiving that grace brings. His eyes gonna be okay, Harpo. Eyes gonna be okay. Sowing the seed is grace. Wealth and riches is the favor that operating in the seed, the ability of sowing, brings. See, saints, money is a divine response from God because you use the talent of herb-bearing seed, which is the third talent that I just spoke about that Adam had. See, saints, y'all get this revelation, right? That money is really spiritual. That's why I can use the money to worship God. That's why I can use the money to show Jesus that I trust him when I sow it. That's why I can be like Solomon and offer up 1,000 burnt offerings and Jesus will come to me and ask me, "What do you want?" Haggai 2:8 said, "The silver and gold is mine," which shows you that Jesus is the possessor of every kind of riches, money, wealth, and substance. Haggai 2:8. And Jesus started talking about the glory. Now, here's what I want you to see. If the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the glory of the former, here's what you got to catch. Our level of sowing and our level of reaping have birthed the next realm of end time glory. Oh my God. Hear me. If the glory of the latter house, and what did the glory in that former house have? riches, wealth. Solomon built a house of gold for God. Golden cups, golden vessels, golden interior, exterior, riches. Living a billionaire and trillionaire status. What does Jacket say? What does it say? Billionaires Club. Billionaires Club. What Solomon tapped into was glory. So his gold began to cometh unto him. See, saints, if you learn to live by the glory of God, no struggles, no acceptance of failure, no distractions. If you start functioning in the glory realm of God, you will be exceedingly rich in this life, and you'll enjoy this life with power, fearlessness, and divine favor backing you from God. Now, let me just say this. Demonic umbrellas is what satanic agents, which are evil spirits that Satan used by the night in the atmosphere, through the internet, through TV, to cause people to stray from the gospel, not be interested in Jesus, not be interested in salvation, not live their life for the Lord, and think that the world has something better for them than living in the spirit. That's what satanic agents, their assignment is to do. To shift your focus off of believing that you need the Lord Jesus. To make you believe that there's other ways to get to heaven. Satanic agents are authors of that. So, satanic agents also have a ministry of umbrellas. I'm teaching you apostolically now. I'm in the apostle's office. See, let me just tell you this. A lot of people, you call yourself apostle. If you are going to be an apostle, you gotta have apostolic realms of wisdom and revelation. Remember, Apostle Paul said, I did not come with persuasive words of man's wisdom. That's another text. Let me deal with what he said. He said that the Lord give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Christ. That's apostolic functionality for government, for benefits, for the system of God to manifest through you. That's where demonstration get out of hand. Out of hand. Out of hand. Out of hand. The Bible said Apostle Paul did many miracles. God did many extraordinary miracles out of the hand of Apostle Paul. It was out of the hand creative miracles. The miracles came, but it came out of the hand. See, there's an out of hand realm that Jesus got for you, where your finances will get out of hand for a good cause. Your wisdom will get out of hand. See, saints, I got out of hand wisdom. So sometimes my sleeping hours, my hours, according to natural men, is off. Because my mind is out of hand. It's out of the hand of the enemy. Oh, my karata. It's out of the hand of vain imaginations. It's out of the hand of every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Out of hand! Out of hand! Jesus was about to multiply the 5 loaves and 2 fish, but he needed to get the 5 loaves and 2 fish out of the little boy's hand. See, if the little boy didn't step into the realm of outer hand, nobody would experience the multiplication of the loaves. So Jesus had to become Saul for this boy to sow out of hand. Oh my God. And then when he sowed out of hand, the fish and the loaves got out of hand. Out of hand. All of the fish and the loaves begin to feed the multitude, over 4,000, over 5,000. It got out of hand. See, out of hand sowing will produce out of hand money coming. Out of hand giving will birth out of hand receiving. The day will come where you will have so much money that you will not know how to count it. The day will come where you will sow so much seeds that you're going to forget how much you sowed in a month. Because it's an outrageous number. It's out of hand. The Bible said, out of the mouth of babes I have perfected praise. So out of the mouth, if God perfected praise, what does he perfect out of hand? Oh my God. Out of eyes, he perfect faith, focus. Out of ears, he perfect the prophetic, teaching you. Out of mouth, he perfected praise. Remember the Bible say, taste and see that the Lord is good? Out of your eyes is divine seeing, divine sight, divine visualization, the ignition of your hope. So if he, out of your legs, your feet, he perfected order. The steps of a good man is ordered by the Lord. Out of your legs, out of your feet. So what did God perfect? Out of hand. Out of your hand, what did he perfect? Sowing, giving, worshiping, bountiful giving, cheerful giving. Investing in Jesus with all your might. See, Jesus told me that Mary Magdalene stopped the reentry of the 7 devils through sowing into me. That's what Jesus told me. He said she was sowing and sowing and sowing into me. So them 7 devils knew that she was connected to me. Demons know who you connected to by your sowing. When a demon see that you sowing into your apostle, your prophet, your man of God, what the demon know, I can't touch you no more. I know I used to manipulate your mind. I know I used to bother you. I know I used to tell you stuff in secret, but I don't have that privilege no more. Saints, did the Bible not tell us that Satan told the Lord, there is a hedge around Job, I can't touch him? Sowing is the architect of hedges. You caught that? Stick with me, children. Sowing is the architect of hedges. And you can have such a hedge around you that the hedge will get out of hand. Even your protection will get out of hand. There's five cars getting an accident on the street, but it don't touch you because your protection out of hand. There'll be five people that died from the heart attack, but you still here because your health, your protection is out of hand. There'll be 10 people that go into bankruptcy. You don't know how you made it off of the little you got, but you made it and you still fine. You're living good because the favor of God is out of hand. See, saints, let me tell you something. The difference between thieves and the difference between true worshipers is this. Thieves look for what's coming out of God's hand. True worshipers get excited about what's coming out of their hands. Oh my God. Oh my God. I need to post that. You ain't my daddy. Shut up. I need to post that. Thieves and true worshipers. A thief will look at what's coming out of God's hand. True worshipers get excited, get ignited about what's coming out of their hands. Saints, I got so much food right now. You know what I got, man? I got pizza. Shoot, I got pizza, man. I got ribs. I got yams. Bro, listen, you don't understand. Saints, how many of y'all had for 4th of July? Y'all ain't know where I was. Well, guess where I was? Man, I was at the state fair. Me and Zendaya jumped into the water together. I jumped into the water with Zendaya. Zendaya was so happy. Got wet. Man, I got wet. That's the only time you're going to hear me say that because it's not a good match. You know, LGBT munch and all this stuff talking some gay pride. Forget y'all. I'm tired of them homosexuals keep on asking me for private sessions. We ain't doing all of that. Wouldn't be like, that's my daddy. Praise God. Somebody come out of the room. That's my daddy. Get him out of here, ushers. Ushers, get him out real quick. Get him out. The usher up there smoking on cigarette tongues. Hold on. I gotta pipe it out. Let me pipe it out. I don't wanna burn the carpet. Money! You got to be radical for somebody. Why not Jesus? You got to be radical for somebody. Why not Jesus? Live your whole life saying that you believe, believe, believe. No, if you believe, you're going to start producing what you believed. You can't be a believer of Jesus and not become rich because faith is not stagnation. Faith is graduation. Faith is graduation. You go from glory to glory. You go from faith to faith. Higher and higher and higher. Higher and higher and higher. Higher and higher and higher. Higher and higher. Higher and higher and higher. You gotta disrespect the sky if you wanna receive your heavenly supply. The sky is not the limit. The sky is a challenger. The sky is not a limit. The sky is a challenger. The Lord will challenge you when you look at the sky and say, you think I can take you higher than this? You got to disrespect the sky if you're going to receive your heavenly supply. Don't become complacent with where you are. Be content. That means praise God. Give him glory. Give him honor. But don't become complacent where you are. There's higher realms. Shoot. Higher realms of virtue. See, saints, let me tell you something. I'm constantly conquering. Constantly conquering. Repesero mo coranta. Don't let what you heard or what you see with your life bother your spirit no more. You living out of hand with favor. With deliverance. Is that right? You need deliverance? Jesus gonna deliver you through the prophet, through the man of God. You just gotta follow through. You just gotta follow through. Being dignified and being diligent are two different systems. Being diligent and dignified are two different kingdoms. You can be dignified. You're not going to learn how to dig. You're not going to learn how to sow. Because you're dignified. You think you know what you need to know, but it's not producing what God said you're supposed to have. So you can be dignified or you can be diligent. Diligence is the secret weapon of students. Diligence is the secret weapon of students. How a student surpasses everybody else in the classroom is because diligence is the basket in which they are packaging divine knowledge. See, you got to package what God teach you. Don't let it go in one ear and out the next ear. See, when God speak to you, after he finished talking, put your headphones on. You know why? Because you want to block that information inside. But you also want to block the information on the outside. Because the information on the outside is not needed. So it don't need to be heeded. You pick the information that God done put inside of you. And you package it. And then your peace going to get out of hand. Then your joy going to get out of hand. Power going to get out of hand. Excellence going to get out of hand. Consistency going to get out of hand. Worship going to get out of hand. Thankfulness going to get out of hand. Glory going to get out of hand. Glory going to get out of hand. All of godly traits going to get out of hand. Because you packaging. In Malachi's day, he was the only one sowing out of hand. So God said, go and prophesy to the people and tell them, they're robbing me. Saints, it would have been hypocritical if Balaam is preaching a message about you need to sow, you need to sow, and he wasn't a sower. God would have struck him down. It's called hypocrisy. The reason why Malachi is qualified by the Lord to talk to them the way that he's talking to them is because he done passed the seed test. He done graduated in sowing. And now God deems him qualified to prophesy about the seed. Oh my God. I want you to hear me. Hear me. When you meet your prophet of God and apostle of God, they're going to prophesy to you about the seed. They're going to prophesy to you about sowing. They're going to give you the mystery about how to stay under the hand of God. Let me tell you something. The worst place that you can, ever be is out of hand with God. Because now you're no longer underneath his hand. You're not listening, not following his hand not able to turn you whichever way you want. You gotta learn how to divinely function in the kingdom's out of hand. See, what God was showing Adam, if you sow out of hand, the woman, if you sow out of hand, this serpent on the outside not going to touch you. What was God showing Ananias and Sapphira? If you sow out of hand, this death angel that's standing right in front of you won't have permission to kill you. Saints, the death angel took them out because they never received the anointing of out of hand. Oh my God. They never received the anointing of out of hand. So the power of God was coming on them strong. They saw the miracles happening. Healings were happening. People was getting delivered. Now Jesus was about to take Ananias and Sapphira into the outer hand realm. And when they got to the outer hand realm, they choked. Peter kept on going. Peter got the harvest that was supposed to come to them. Because you can snatch seed assignments. You can snatch seed assignments. You can snatch sowing assignments. Who you think got the harvest? Peter. You can intercept those who are being intercepted by the devil. The demonic umbrella come to stop the rain. Elijah said, I hear the sound of the abundance of rain. So, what's going to stop the rain? The water can't touch you if you got an umbrella. See, let me say this to you. This is so powerful. A lot of women, you'll catch me on this. You don't want to get your hair wet, right? When you get your hair done, you don't want to get your hair wet. Let me show you something. Sowers get their hair wet. You know how I know? Because watch this. When the woman with the alabaster box, she poured out that costly oil, she wiped his feet with her what hair? If you're going to step into supernatural finances, supernatural harvests, supernatural money, you got to get your hair wet. If you're going to step into supernatural money, supernatural finances, you're going to have to do things that you normally would protect yourself from. You caught that? You're going to have to do things that you normally would avoid. Saints, do you know that Peter was avoiding the tax collectors? So Jesus said, Peter. See, you're avoiding them because you got a broke spirit. No. You rich, Peter. And I'm going to show you how you rich. I'm about to pull from your supernatural account because you're the greatest soul in my ministry. I'm about to show you what you made of, Peter. Pay the daggone debt. Pay it off. And I'm going to put the money in the fish mouth. You ever wonder why Jesus only did supernatural money with Peter? Because Peter was the largest sower in Jesus' ministry. So Jesus reveals to him supernatural money. Jesus reveals to him out of hand sowing and out of hand reaping. Supernatural money coming out of hand. It got out of hand. And watch this. When it got out of hand, it started showing up in animals' mouth. Saints, you probably never thought about this as strong like this, but I'm about to say something to you. Elijah had out of hand provision because Elijah was an out of hand sower. You know that he was a sower because when he went go destroy the prophets of Baal, before he did it, he offered up a sacrifice of God unto God and the fire of God fell. Which shows you that my sowing can access the fire of God. So then people that always with their cock-a-doodle-doo, commonsensical mind, telling some, oh, I just want to heal the sick. I just want to move in miracle ministry. I don't want no money. I don't care about that money and all that different type of stuff. I don't want none of that. None of that, none of that, none of that. I just want to heal the sick and just want to go around. Oh, catch my teeth. My teeth on the ground. Pick up my dentures. All right. Thank you, baby. I don't want none of that stuff. I just want to. Sowing accesses the fire of God. Because Elijah did that to access the fire of God. He got the fire of God to fall through his sowing. Because remember when the prophets of Baal, they went go sowing to their God, nothing responded. That show you that if you sowing, and is not Holy Spirit led and driven, is not really sowing. It's to a false god, Satan. He'll make you give inaccurately. And those are vanity seeds. There's a saturation of the glory and grace of God for wealth. There's a saturation of the grace, the glory, the power, the fire of the Holy Spirit for riches. When the financial fire of God is on you, you stop danger, tragedy. You burn up the cords of wickedness in your path during the day. When demons fight you as a sower, they're not going to win. Because the financial fire of God is there to burn up every battle that will even stand against you ever. The financial fire and favor of God are both shields, hedges, guardians. See, when you sowing, you unlock the angels called guardians. And these angels are there to stop calamity and destruction from touching you. You ever wondered why Job chapter 5 verse 22 says this? That you shall laugh at famine, that's financial issues. You gonna laugh at financial issues. Why? Because you ain't got no issues with your finances. You gonna laugh at famines, that mean money stoppeth. See, money stoppeth is adversarial to your birthright. Money stoppeth. Somebody write that statement down. Money stoppeth is adversarial to your birthright. is adversarial to your blood-bought son and daughter covenant with God. Money stoppeth. Demonic umbrellas. Demonic umbrellas. Money stoppeth. Now watch this. I want to speak on this real quick. Don't let Satan block up your wells. Don't let Satan block up your wells. You heard? You heard? You heard? Because watch. When Satan block up your wells, here's what begin to happen. There's an umbrella over you so that you'll never experience the radical and passionate investments of God for you to enjoy your life. You'll never experience it. See, Satan wanna shut up your wells.
One of the fifth spirit, man, I want everyone to hear it. I can't stop it, no, slow it down. Heaven is opening more and down. Miracles happening, people are free. Crippled man healed in the blood can see. Mothers and daughters are getting along. Daddies and sons are coming back home. I see hands up, people looking like drones. Praise King Jesus who sits on the throne. Blood money washed away all my wrongs. Since I had it, still I'm gone. Oh, why should I live like a zombie? No,
Genesis chapter 26, verse 15. Genesis 26, 15. For all the wells that Abraham, which was Isaac's father, all of the wells which his father's servants had digged in the days of Abraham, his father, the Philistines has stopped them. The Philistines stopped them and filled them with earth. Uh-oh. Underlay, underlay, underlay. E-I, E-I. Look at this. Ain't this about a Nelly? And we're not talking about Furtado or El Dorado. What you want? What you want? Want? Genesis 26. Ever since I'm mad at Chinese people now, you call me what you want, a racist. I met two Chinese people I ain't like, what, earlier today. The lady up at the bank, I'm trying to get under the bank, nigga. If you don't get your Chinese looking self out of my way, if you don't speak English, you shouldn't be dealing with money. Where the manager at here? This lady was so lost, she took my bank. I'm at a certain bank. She called another bank, asking them about me. Can I get some money from them? Lady, what are you doing? Oh, I didn't understand. I thought you didn't understand, nigga. You understand, nigga? What you doing up in here? Who does... How you won't call another bank and ask them to give me money? No, I'm here. I'm here. What? Got to the daggone airport. Somebody looked just like her sitting down in a chair. I'm like, nigga, how did you get from the bank to here? Gia said they both related. They got the same spirit. See, Jesus don't be confused about people because most of them be looking alike because they're the same spirit. Saints, I went inside the airport and the lady up there sitting down right there on the side of me. I'm like, what? This is the same lady that I just saw at the bank. How did she get right here? You say what you want. Don't you get tired, daggone it? When you talking to people in America, they don't understand no English. Dang. So I gotta learn another language to talk to you? Nah, I ain't doing it. I'm just gonna go around you. Now you think it's just Chinese and black people too. They want to talk in patois. You ever met them people? Meet somebody from Haiti. It's not just no Chinese people. Chinese people talk about your foot in another language. Nah, it's not the Chinese, the Vietnamese. It's not them that's going to talk about your big toenail. You got shack toenails. It got shack toenails. You got shack toenails. You say, oh, you want to do my nails? Oh, she hear what I said. She hear what I said. Shh. It got shack toenails. It's not just the Vietnamese that are going to talk about your feet. Haiti people. Haiti people were talking another language against you. You get around somebody from Haiti. They be like, why is it? Why are you sopping it up like that? Never mind. I know you're talking about me. I know you're talking about me. I understand. I know you're talking about me. I feels it. I feels it. I feel the vibe that's coming from you. You're talking about me. Black people do it too. Spanish people do it too. When they get ready, they switch to that other language, start talking about you. Genesis chapter 26. Genesis chapter 26. Look at verse 15. For all the wells which Abraham's servant had digged were stopped up by the Philistines and filled with earth. Now, saints, I want you to see this. Why is the wells able to be stopped up? The sowing was not intact. Nobody was functioning out of hand. Let me show you this. God had to surround Isaac with a time in his life that he hated being in. God had to surround Isaac with a scenery, with occurrences that he dreaded to train his hands to sow. Sons and daughters, I come to tell you that the very fire that you go through is either God taking you to another level in your sowing, or he taking you into the level of sowing because you departed long time ago. Either he taking you to the next level, or he taking you to the level because you never even stepped into one yet. Just because you see an elevator doesn't mean that you're riding in one. Do you know I can see an elevator and not ride in it? They say, is the elevator right here? Yeah, the elevator right here. I'm looking for an elevator. Can you help me find it? Yeah, it's right here. Just because I know where the elevator is doesn't mean that I'm in the elevator. You gotta move and press the button. You gotta press. And then you gotta make a decision which level you wanna be on. Which level has what you're trying to reach. Which level is carrying what you wanna possess. And then you gotta press the button. And then you gotta step. Because the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Now the Lord gonna give you order to bring that level. To bring that level to pass. Somebody write the word step. Everybody on the line, write the word step. Write the word step right now. Keep on writing the word step. I'm about to show you something. Now, write the word step with the period inside of it. Write S, period. T, period. E, period. P, period. I'm going to show you what the Holy Ghost told me. I'm going to show you something. I heard the Holy Spirit speak this to me. I never heard this a day in my life. The steps of a good man ordered by the Lord. I just heard Jesus speak this to me. And some of you all, you're not really all that way knowledgeable. Well, how he tells and the Holy Spirit speak to him. And then he said, Jesus. That's how I know he's a false prophet. I know that he's a false prophet. Look at what he said, Eldarine. Eldarine, listen to me. I know you don't want to listen to me, but I'm going to tell you the truth however you like it, baby. He said the Holy Ghost told him, then he said Jesus told him. See, he lying. The Holy Ghost is Jesus' spirit. The Holy Ghost is Jesus. The God of all the earth is Jesus. The God of the world is Satan. Because the world is not this planet. The world is a thought life that hates what Jesus says as the God over the earth. So no wonder Apostle Paul taught you apostolically, don't be conformed to the world. What he's saying, don't adapt to hating me with your mind. Don't let them teach you how to hate me. See, saints, you see how Jesus is so sweet? He cried out through the text to apostle, through his apostle, and said, no, don't let them get you to adapt to what I said is wrong. It don't matter how many two men you see walking together. They ain't really married. Them just two demons. Acting like plum fools. Don't worry about two girls that you see walking together, Thompson, that's my wife. It's just two demons. Two fools. Somebody write the word step one more time. Yeah, because that stuff anger me. You see a man talking to my husband. I'm not going to adapt to the bull crap and the nonsense. I don't care if they pass a law. I don't care about how many of these so-called Christian people talking to them. Well, we got to respect everybody. I ain't respecting nobody that's rebelling against God. I'll tell you that right now. I ain't got no respect. If you ain't got respect for Jesus, I ain't got respect for you. You can sit right here. All these people up there want to rise up. If you can't stand up for what Jesus stand up for, then you're an enemy of Jesus. It don't matter if you preach the word. If you're against what he preached and you're against his word, it don't matter how much you call his name and say that you love him, that's a lie. If you loved him, he said, if you love me, keep my commandments. I want everybody, write me that step one more time. S-T-E-P. It's powerful stuff here. It's powerful. I'm going to show you what the Holy Ghost spoke to me. And this is amazing. When it said the step of a good man is ordered by the Lord, sowing to enter prosperity. Sowing to enter prosperity. You're never going to look at the word step another day the same way. Because apostolically, I'm giving you a new wave. Remember I gave you that revelation about Deuteronomy 28? We're going to celebrate that every day from now on. For the rest of our lives, we're going to celebrate Jesus. And we're going to rejoice in him. And I'll teach on that day as well, Lord willing, Lord willing, Lord willing. The Bible said when you talk about the future, say, Lord willing. See, that keep you humble. Yeah, you can talk boldly about certain things. God will tell you talk boldly about certain things. But when you up in the air about stuff and you know that you made the plans and you don't got the real confidence that it's really the Lord behind the plans, you say, Lord willing, I'm going to finish my college degree. Stupid! I'm playing around. Going to college, ain't got no money. That's a demon. Who got you up in college? I'm sacrificing that. I get there. But you skin and bones. You ain't got no money to buy no food. You buying books. You in debt. When you could start making money, get a job, start sowing into your man of God, let the anointing do its work, watch how the kingdom overtake you, and Jesus, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, make men give it to your bosom, and you be a multimillionaire in the 4 years that you was about to go to school. Don't regret your past. Create your future. You hear what I said? I said, don't regret your past. Just create your future. See, what I'm telling you is not for you to condemn yourself. Oh, I should have did that. No, no, no. I'm showing you how you at a higher level because your mind didn't change. Regret is a revelation of higher wisdom. Glory to God. That's a wisdom door. Somebody write that down. Regret is a revelation of higher wisdom. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Sowing to enter prosperity. So saints, for now on, you say, I'm a step. I'm sowing to enter prosperity. Ma karato kuramantiko. Ha! Ho! Ho! Ho, the glory of God. Ho! Ho! I'm sowing to enter prosperity. I refuse to live some average life. When I got God Almighty on my side, I'm going to let him bring me out. I'm going to let him destroy the yoke. I'm going to let him set me free. I'm going to let him walk in me, talk in me, move in me. In him, I live, I move, I have my being. See. I'm sowing to enter prosperity. What is prosperity? God giving me the absence of demonic activity ruling my life. When I step, I'm destroying all opportunities of Satan. See, sowing, it birthed God opportunities. But it break demonic opportunities. You caught that? Sowing it birth God opportunities, but it break. It break. It's breaking right now. It break all the demons in your soul. It break all the demons in your soul. It break. See, sowing is a bridge for the blessing to be bestowed upon your bosom. Your bosom's supposed to be saturated with wealth and riches. Do you know who you are? Royalty. You can sow out of the royalty realm. That's how you unlock royalty checks, royalty treatment, royalty favor, royalty mindset, royalty wisdom. You can sow out of the royalty realm. Bible says you're a royal priesthood. So here's what happens. What did the priest become soil in Malachi? The prophet Malachi began to prophesy and talk about how the priests keep knowledge, he give you knowledge, and the priest is the soil to receive the tithes and the offerings. So when it say that you are a royal priesthood, it's a revelation that God going to anoint you to be soil. Oh my God. See, if you receive that priestly anointing, you've been destined by God to not only be wise, not only be knowledgeable, not only to be great in your understanding, to have an Issachar anointing, an Issachar anointing, an Issachar grace. But you've been called to be Saul. Praise God. Somebody say hallelujah on here. Hallelujah. See, what's so powerful is, not only have you been called to be a sower, you've been called to be Saul. So now hereby you understand the apostolic mystery of Luke 6:38. It's sowing and Saul grace. Luke 6:38 is sowing and Saul grace. We're going to break the neck of the enemy. We're about to pour money coming. When we pour money cometh right now, we're about to break the neck of the enemy. When we pour money cometh right now, all demonic strongholds are going to be broken. Money cometh to me now. We're going to pour it a second time. Because now we are in the dispensation of sowing and Saul grace. The Lord not going to let your situation stay in the same place. But he has given you the power to step. Sowing to enter prosperity. And prosperity means that God becomes your partner. To stop all the satanic activity, powers, and partnerships that you created in your ignorance. Stuff that you birthed in your life because you didn't listen to God. Stuff that you allowed to enter your mind, your soul, because you wasn't focusing on what the Lord said. All those barriers that been bothering your destiny and inheritance be broken right now as we pull. Money cometh to me now. This third time we pulling. Somebody say Medina Pullins, Medina Pullins. I ain't say no Medina Pullins. Bless Medina Pullins. I ain't say that. I said this third time we pull in. Huh? You understand? You understand? This third time we pull in. We speak into the banks. You know how Moses said, let my people go? Let my money go. We speak into the earth realm. The Bible said that the earth is crying out for the manifestation of the sons of God, because when the sons of God come, the decree and anointing step, the sowing anointing step, and authority, apostolic authority is restored back to the earth. When we pour this last time, we speak into the atmosphere, every bank, every thief, every wicked hand that got my wealth, I command you to release my wealth. Right now, I loose it by apostolic power as I decree this word. Every financial demon, every locust, caterpillar, palmer worm, every demon be broken now in Jesus' mighty name. Money! How? 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 We're not waiting for this to happen. It's already happening. My people are already coming out with their silver and gold. It's already happening. No, no. We not waiting for nothing to happen. It's already happening. We are in a financial move of God.